Thank you. Yeah. That's what I really need. That's the conversation that is more needed.
So here we are in the beautiful city of Manchester. We've got a sign here. It says, "There's no argument against being vegan. Prove me wrong." We're going to see if anyone can find a really good argument for them not to be vegan. And yeah, hopefully we have some good discussions about it. Let's do it.
Wait, we've got someone here laughing. Wait. Look, there's someone here laughing. Stop laughing straight away and got all serious when they seen the camera, hey? Eating McDonald's, laughing at the vegan sign.
Where are all the people coming to debate me now? Yeah, yeah. Come and debate Joey. Come and debate him right now.
So obviously there are arguments to not be vegan, like in certain hypotheticals, like survival situation. You might not be able to choose what you eat, say if you're homeless or something like this, but I'm talking about when the person sits down, when the individual sits down, I want to know why they're not vegan. There's no argument against them being vegan.
This is going to be a pee. You're going to have a pee in the back side with me.
Oh, really? I like them. Okay. I like difficult challenges.
Okay.
How are you, mate?
I'm not too bad.
So, what's your name?
George.
George, I'm Joey. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Joey. Right, so I have no real argument against veganism. As in, like, you can be vegan and live your life normally and have a fun time. But you're saying that there's a choice between either being vegan or not being vegan. Then there's a whole idea, if veganism is the better alternative, then should there be a conversation of changing it all into, like, veganism? So there shouldn't be any, like, you know, if I went to a pizza place, actually all of it's fake pizza. Actually, there'd be no reason to make meat, because that's actually wasting more time. Also carbon emissions as well, with like pigs and all sorts. They're taking up more space as well, so you should reduce that down. So, then it kind of wraps itself in the nutshell. Is there anything that we can do to change the actual argument of eating meat?
Yeah.
Is there? Because,
I personally think, like, you skipped over something here, which is really important. It's that animals are being executed en masse, tortured and murdered for a needless thing like a burger. I mean, there's these massive, there's these big slaughterhouses all over. Like, there's actually one here in Manchester. This is pigs.
Aye.
You know, this is me inside of a pig farm here.
Oh, wow.
And these are called farrowing sheds, where the mothers are kept in here while piglets are feeding.
Mm.
So they're kept in here for weeks on end.
Mm.
And then they mutilate these piglets, of course, take their tails off, snip their teeth out, and then they chuck them in this thing here.
Yeah. Oh. I just see that.
This is a gas chamber,
yeah,
dude.
This is a gas chamber.
Fucking horrific.
They've got one out here at Manchester, Tulip Meats, and you can hear the pigs screaming from out the front of it.
That is horrific.
Yeah.
So this is CO2, and it burns their eyes and insides and lungs, and they struggle and try to escape. Horrible.
Yeah, that's...
They're actually screaming really loud, but I've got the sound off. Yeah, it's... So,
okay.
Like, this here for me, right, this is where the argument is here.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think there's anything that justifies this. That's why I say there's no argument against being vegan like you guys, like right now here in the UK. Like, you know, I think there are arguments where there's like some hypothetical survival situation where you have to do what you've got to do.
Yeah.
But I think for the most part, you guys here, like, should be vegan. I don't see an argument against it.
Well, it's the problem I hate to say it, but it's convenience over necessity, isn't it? You have to make it more convenient to be vegan than it is to be more necessary to be in a carnivore, or like someone who's going to just eat meat, or on the variousness, or what, I don't really know the jargon, but
I think it's an omnivore kind of a meat eater. I agree that convenience is a massive factor.
Yes.
But let's just say for you, like, now that you're educated, like, do you know what goes on?
That's lovely.
That's called an electro ejaculator. They force the bull to ejaculate so they can take the semen and inject it into the female. This is the dairy industry. Do you think this is...
No, it's not. It's not.
This is okay?
No, it's not. It's not fun, and it's not not really necessary.
Now, what he does is he puts his fist in the female's anus to hold the cervix, and then he will inject the bull semen in her.
Yeah.
That's how dairy's made.
Yeah, I know. And it's seeing it is like...
Perverted?
It's disgusting, but...
It's a calf.
It is, hasn't it? It's a hard, like, I've got family who've been farmers, they've worked in cattle, they've worked in pig farms, and my dad, it was mostly a chicken farm, and it suddenly become pigs, and then he stopped working. It's like, oh, why did you stop working? Just a smile of shit. Yeah. Just a genuine just smile of rubbish and, like...
So much feces comes out of these places, yeah. Where do they put all that shit?
I don't... Well,
they spray it around, keep it in these big pits.
It's more for manure, isn't it? So they'll keep reusing it. So there's a question of cycle of life, isn't it? But then, like...
The circle of life, you mean?
Yeah, but I don't... I'm not trying to...
Is this the circle of life?
No, I'm not trying to... This is
like the circle of murder.
Yeah, this is what I mean. It's condoning something where you, like... The whole inherent... Like, us choosing that we have more dominance over killing animals is... inherently wrong. I see
the might makes right argument, you know, like, because we're more powerful and mighty, than anything we do to those who we deem weaker than us is therefore morally justified.
It's not on.
We've done it to each other all throughout history.
I know, so
it's a horrible way of looking at life, isn't it?
For me, I feel like the only way that you're going to like nullify or like to fix a wrong, Because this is where your argument really needs to, I'd feel like this is where we have to go into.
The solution?
Yeah, solutions. So, firstly, it's inevitable that the fact of you showing all these videos might put, like, it's put me...
That's horrible, isn't it? That's right, a dairy cow being slaughtered when she can't produce milk anymore.
I know, but I've still got chili con carne cooking. Yeah. I'm still going to eat
her body?
No, I mean, it's not her. Oh,
their heads. When you go sit down to a burger, dude, when you sit down to a burger, you're eating the suffered body of someone who's tried to survive.
I know.
So they're trying to escape the knockbox here. You know, these are the beings that you're eating when you eat their body. A piece of someone.
I know. And it's horrendous.
It's needless. You don't need to. Like, I've been vegan 7 years.
So how much does it cost you?
Well, it depends, as much as I want it to.
Okay, so...
The cheapest foods in the supermarket, rice, beans, vegetables, fruits, soy milk about a pound a bottle.
Noticed any nutritional defects or any affects?
I supplement with B12, just to be safe.
Yeah.
I think everyone should...
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so supplement with B12. Because this is, I think that's another conversation that has to be put into place, is the idea of how can I, because there's a whole other point of saying that veganism isn't that, like, nutritional.
What argument based on that? Have you seen any of the science to do with our plant-based diets?
No, yes and no. Yes in the sense, because there's an idea of keto diet, but that still involves meat. There is an idea of plant-based diets. This is my only issue, is that the fact of hearing it and knowing it and doing something about it are all three different facets that have to be...
Would you be worried about your health if you ate plant-based diet?
Yes, if I suddenly started getting dizzy, because if
there was some type of symptom from it, but I mean,
yes and no.
But are you worried that you can't get the nutrients that you get right now, what you're eating in a day, that you can't get that on a plant-based diet?
Yeah, no. Like, I don't know.
What do you think? You'd be missing? Like, what nutrient do you think you'd be missing?
I think it's more of a. I think it's more of a habitual thing, really. The idea of enjoying something that. Like, I've had a burger, I know what it smells like, I know what it tastes like, and I know for a fact it's a burger. Like, there's no carbs, no nothing. Give me an impossible burger, and then I eat that with no mither, no massive. I've had corn chicken, I've had corn lasagna. It's just, for me, more of, I don't really know what to get. Like, I feel like
there's just a lack of education here
I'm not saying that I don't, it's not that I'm not against you or whatever, it's just more of...
Well, you're more... When you're not vegan, you're against the animals. What you do affects them. It's not affecting me what you do. Yeah. You're affecting these victims. Yeah. This is why I'm here. Not here to force my lifestyle on you. I want you to stop forcing your lifestyle on the animals.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
Because you're forcing them into these slaughterhouses and forcing them to die.
Yeah. Just when you say those words, it is very...
You paid for this. This is me trying to save someone.
Oh.
I'm in a farm trying to rescue this chick here. This is a sanctuary for her.
Do you want to be this guy, or
do you want to be the guy who sends him to slaughter?
I don't want to be neither, mate. I don't want to have any part in this. So there has to be a conversation of trying to cut this out entirely.
Yeah.
But can we and shall we, and isn't us being full vegan the same way of, like, you know, is people going to see this as like, oh, they're stopping us from eating meat now? Or like, are they seeing it as oppression? Are they seeing it as censored?
Who do you think's being oppressed here?
Oh, the chickens, obviously. Yeah, every day.
If I said to you, you can't eat this anymore, would you feel like the one who's being oppressed? Or would you say, wait a second, this is the egg industry macerating male chicks, by the way. They're being killed because they don't produce eggs for humans.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm more of seeing it as everybody else. Because it's a business, isn't it?
Let's say
if you stop all this, right? Because you're going to start chicken farmers.
Gradually.
So there has to be a conversation. What are you going to do with those farmers? Like, what jobs are they also going to... Like, I guess they do plant farm.
What did the slave owners do?
Most of them got paid off anyway.
I'm making an analogy here. So slavery was legal. Big industry, rice and cotton, tobacco, I think, even. So what happened when they had to...
Did they? Like, basically, because they were treated as property, and because
the slaves got paid back.
No. The slave owners. Because they were considered as property, and because they destroyed most of their, like, you know, their income of rice and everything else, they had to pay them back. It sounds awful. I hate, like, that whole situation.
But they abolished slavery, didn't they?
Yeah. Fantastic. But still, someone had to be paid for it. Okay. So it comes back to this. Perfect example. So with this, they'll have to pay them. So we
could help the farmers out, you mean?
Yeah, basically. Yeah. And I hope that would be the case.
I think that we should help all human beings out.
Especially if their industry has gone down. This is spinning around the circles.
I really don't think that what happens in that industry morally justifies this industry.
It doesn't at all. But there's a situation of like, is there a petition I can sign? Is there?
No. Okay, this is where we are. We're at this right now. So, what I want to talk about is your personal contribution.
Okay, what am I going to do about it? Well, I want to, so...
For starters, what do you think the most powerful point of control you have right now is?
Is...
I don't want you to sign a petition.
Yeah,
I don't want you to give me any money.
Yeah.
I want you to... What do you do when you go like this?
Just instead of it being like meatballs, it's like...
Vegan meatballs.
Yes.
Linda McCartney's vegan meatballs. Yes.
Okay, then.
It's a Beyond Burger.
Yeah. Yes.
It's corn vegan ham.
Yeah, I get you. I understand that. I just don't... I'll do it. Fuck it.
You know what? I'll tell you something.
Imagine if I was sitting here, can you 100%? Okay, then. I know. I'll do it this way, because you know this might be a better way. How can you turn a meat eater into someone who's vegan, who's never done it before and has no idea what he's doing, and is more scared of what to get and not?
I've got a little bit of resource here.
That would be fantastic.
Okay. So here we go. Like, look. So I've got these. I've got the pamphlets out, guys. We've got these. Project manager made these ones.
Oh.
But okay. So first, you educate yourself. Job. Obviously. This is education. This is what happens in the slaughterhouses and environment and health. This is where you can get stuff.
Okay.
So you can get vegan options from these places. KFC sometimes has a vegan burger.
Mm.
Okay, so here, this is called Happy Cow app.
Okay.
This app will show you restaurants that have vegan options near you. Most of the coffee places you can get vegan milks.
Okay.
Choose one you like. I like oat milk myself, but you might like soya milk.
Well, I've tried soy milk before, so I've tried... So when it comes to corn, chicken, like, I don't notice the difference. Honest, I've had it in curry, it is fantastic. Like, there's no qualms with me at all. It's just... Yeah, I'm guessing I'm just being a bit too naive and being too stupid of a situation. But if there's, you know, if there's 10,000 of me, can you stop 10,000? This is where thank you for making me 100% realize, because this kind of conversation is sad that it has to happen, but it's necessary, it's needed. It is brutally destroying for me and for anybody else who'd be watching this, that the fact that they have to I have to come to a realization now that, look, I know for a fact, because I'm gonna never forget this conversation, to be honest, because for me it's just going, it's being blind but then being ignorant, but then how much ignorance are you willing to take until you become ignorant? How much is it, I'm wearing a mask right now. This whole conversation with, if COVID wasn't happening about as well, and that idea of oppression and just, it's not oppression really, because there's always two sides, so yeah. We have to make middle grounds.
I think what you need to do in this situation when we're talking about animal rights is look at it through the eyes of the real victim here.
You
have your human rights here.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about me coming up and enslaving you and killing you. I mean, I'd be breaking the law if I did.
Yeah.
But right now,
but there's nothing
legally
stopping you though.
You can. There's nothing stopping me except for the law, and I will go to prison forever.
Yeah.
But with these animals, they can legally be herded up into gas chambers and murdered so you can buy their tortured, suffered body and eat it. You can legally do that. But the only thing stopping you is your conscience and your ethics.
Okay.
And then you can make the decision to stop your contribution to this, and then you can talk to other people about it and make an impact that. So you're not going to stop all the people out here from doing bad things. You can't. No. You can only control what you do.
Yeah.
And just because you can't stop everything from going on out here doesn't give you, carte blanche to go do what you want.
Thank you. Yeah. That's what really need. That's the conversation that is more needed. Yeah. Is the fact of saying, look, maybe you shouldn't be doing this just because everybody else is. Yeah. Are you going to be the wolf or are you going to be the sheep? Yeah. It's very much that.
Imagine
conversation.
If millions of us all went vegan. That would have an impact. Millions of people are going vegan.
I would hope
but
so.
But it's going to have an impact.
Okay, so if we're talking methane, carbon emissions, the idea of everything else, there has to be also a conversation of coal and actually subsidising energy plants and also sorting those out as well at the same time as doing this.
This is an environmental top.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's environmental altogether.
There was a big study by
protecting the animals. Then you're sorting out the CO2 emissions,
and then
from there, then you've got to sort out the coal emissions and everything else. Then you've got energy and how we innovate to make it more efficient to make those.
These are conversations we need to have.
But
what you can personally do now, and there was a study by Oxford University that said it was on 40,000 farms in 119 countries, and they concluded by saying that eating a vegan diet is the single biggest thing you can do to reduce your impact on planet Earth. But this is, for me, is an animal rights issue. Veganism is about, if you think of veganism as a philosophy against the exploitation and cruelty to animals, that's what being a vegan is.
Okay.
It's like when you say, I'm against racism, I don't like racism. Yeah. That's a philosophy you adhere to. Yeah. You don't practice it sometimes. You don't stop being vegan on a Tuesday. You're a vegan because it's a philosophy that you adhere to.
Okay. So it's very much like either being a stoicism or very much a utilitarianism, the idea of just trying to stick to your guns and sticking to your principles.
You're anti-animal abuse, so you're not going to go and eat an abused animal or pay for them to be tortured in a slaughterhouse.
No, I don't want to at all. Don't want to at all. Yeah. Thank you very much.
I appreciate your time. This is called Challenge 22.
Okay.
This is a free website. You can go on there, do a vegan challenge on Facebook.
Okay.
They help you out. They guide you. They give you the... It goes for 22 days because it takes 21 days to rebuild a new habit. And this is just a new habit you can rebuild.
So there's a conversation. So you would be sort of killing the animals, finding them a new place.
What would happen is if gradually, as more and more people go vegan and stop funding these industries, they stop producing, breeding so many animals into existence, and it phases out over time.
Yeah.
If not, there's some direct action that stops the government, political action that stops the government from and forces the government to phase these industries out.
There's veganism, and then you've got racism, political problems. It's a very much a conversation of what takes precedence, really. Yeah. We can't keep keeping our lives as the top wall. Really, animals, I would make a massive argument that you should sort out the animals first, get that all sorted, and then hopefully, with us being a bit more humanitarian to animals, we might treat ourselves as more human to everybody else.
Yeah.
I feel like it's that simple, really, because that's where we're coming from, our own roots in the first place. But if there was a more of a less manufacturing, less mass manufacturing of like milking, and less mass manufacturing of like more of an organic route. But yeah, again, if you watch the second documentary of Super Size Me, he talks about how organic is just like a vague word, so they can basically fit.
The labelling is really untrustworthy.
Yeah, yeah. Like
organic animals are still stabbed in the throat, so I don't want any of that.
No, like that's. But so you would never. Oh, that's an egg. Yeah, eggs. Yeah. That's what I mean. It's just
eggs are exploited hens who get murdered when their egg production declines, and the males are all macerated as a chicks because they don't produce eggs. So the industry, organic and free, they're all horrible to animals.
I know.
If you go to these backyard farms, these homestead farms where there's only a few animals out there, and they're like, okay, this bacon comes from this really humanely treated animal, but it's a chopped up animal.
Okay.
Like that's where the rights violation is. You're chopping this animal up and eating them. Come on.
Even with an egg, you're still chopping up something that's like a fetus or something that's, you know, could have been born anyway.
Well, I think they're unfertilized eggs, so the rights violation comes when they're being mass exploited, and then there's the backyard egg argument.
Okay, what's that?
So the backyard egg argument is like, okay, so...
if you have your own chickens, you can have your own eggs.
Well, it depends where you're sourcing these chicks from, because if you source them from a hatchery, the males are all getting macerated anyway, so you're still supporting that industry.
So you're better off just taking how many... you're better off just taking a 50-50 roosters and... roosters and hens.
Well, the hens also need to eat their eggs back because they've been selectively bred to produce 300 eggs a year when they usually only produce like an egg a month.
Okay.
You know, so like they lose their calcium in their body, they need their egg back. But I always think like stop viewing animals as a resource, because this is where factory farms began.
Yeah.
That this mentality towards animals that they're here for us.
Yeah. And then not real.
Then they were all backyard eggs before, and then what happened? Everyone wants eggs.
I just. Yeah. So but then there's a whole conversation. We wouldn't have this right now. You wouldn't have a camera, or we wouldn't have a microphone if half of this, like, you know, standardizing of like, or domestication of animals. Yeah. If this doesn't come about, then we would have more of a.
I'm not against technology or civilization, by the way.
I didn't think you were. It sounds weird, but if this didn't happen in the first place, then we wouldn't. So now it's more of a conversation of bringing it back. It's more of a conversation of paying homage to what we've done and what we should be doing instead. Does that make any sense?
We can have technology, we can have civilization. There are deaths that are going to happen because we live, like road accidents, and animals are dying because of crops and things like this. But I think if we take out these trillions of animals being executed every year, then we've done a massive good thing.
Okay. Well, yeah, I'd love to keep talking.
No, that's fine.
But
I appreciate your time.
Spinning around in the same circles. I'll just put the main points here. No. There needs to be change. And I love that this YouTube, or is it a YouTube channel, I'm guessing?
Yeah,
or
yeah.
Channel, is it on
the... It's actually, if you open up, this here is my name here.
Okay. Yeah. Nice to meet you, Joey. So it's going to be on Vimeo, I'm guessing?
This is my name on YouTube as well. Okay. But this is where this will be.
Fair dues. Well, you might get a follow, subscribe.
No worries, brother.
You know, keep up the good work.
I hope
Thank
this
you
is woken you up a little bit to
it
what's going on.
It is woken me up, but at the same time, I'm like...
The power's in your hands. Don't overwhelm yourself. Just focus on what you can do.
Yeah. But you are doing the overwhelming part, if that makes any sense. So then there has to be a conversation of like, do you do like nutritional facts? Do you do like a weekly diet, or is it all on the YouTube channel? Do you have a YouTube video?
There's information here about nutrition and health.
No, I mean in the sense of, will you or do you want me? A YouTube video with like someone who's never done veganism before to trying to do veganism, like the whole idea of going from zero to hero, essentially.
What do you want to film a video with you and feeding you?
Well, if you want, I'll pay for it.
Well, how about we take you? Okay. How about we take you to the shops and go get you what you need?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. Well, put my body where my office, right?
We'll take his email and that, eh?
Okay.
We'll take a contact from you then.
Fantastic.
All right. I'll give you the email and we'll continue this on part two.
Well, okay then.
No worries, brother.
Fantastic.
Take care, mate. Nice talking to you, man. Yeah. Eh? That was the most motivated, awake new vegan I've ever seen. I honestly don't see
much holding him back. So yeah, we'll see if we can take him out. Take him out, do some vegan shopping. Set up his new vegan lifestyle. Hey? I think he inspired everyone to do this. Yeah, it's good. It's a good. Yeah, yeah, it's good. It's a really good format. I really like it. Yeah, it's great. Yeah. Take care, man.
Louder with Crowder didn't inspire me. Earthling Ed did.
I just got a chicken cheeseburger.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't leave. Nah, don't be scared. Come on, don't be shy. Tell me about it. What'd you get? Cheese and chicken?
Yeah,